is it?
1,000 milligrams per month, biomechanically, is basically almost nothing. So here it is 20, 30 years later to find out that it was all about nothing. And the only reason you age is because your testosterone level drops. And your testosterone level drops, the nutrient drops, and the protein synthesis drops. That's why you age. So if your testosterone is at a normal level throughout your whole life, you could literally go to 150 looking like you're 35. So we have the uneducated median targeting this level of negativity over people who pay $800 for a hot dog, $215 for a beer. So they want to see the ball knocked out of the park, but we're at a level of professionalism. I got to hear your input on this, please.
My question is simple. Why is tobacco legal, which says it will kill you, causes cancer? Why is that legal?
It says on the label.
Why is liquor legal? You don't know how many hundreds of thousands of people die of sclerosis of the liver every United States of America? It's amazing.
And liquor, it's a poison. Every corner of the nation.
Liquor is a poison. How many deaths are directly linked with testosterone level? None so far.
Zero.
People talk. Oh, this individual was taking PED, was taking testosterone, and he died. But you know what? They don't realize the other things he was using, cocaine, marijuana, liquor, the other additives, the crack cocaine, they were combining with.
It was the testosterone.
And it wasn't the testosterone.
It kept them alive through the shit.
So the issue is, why are some things legal that are known to kill hundreds of thousands of people every year? And testosterone, PEDs are illegal, and they have not been linked that even once directly to one death. Does that make sense to you?
If that's not educated
not
common
that,
sense,
let me get deeper. We produce naturally testosterone. Do we naturally produce tobacco or nicotine or alcohol in our system?
No.
It's an alien to our system. So what we're really doing is we're adding extra testosterone that we have naturally through our whole life cycle. And as we get older, it starts depleting in our system. We need to do this, maintain the highest testosterone level possible to have our youth as long as possible. That makes sense. The rest makes no sense.
So in this conversation, do you think the media would say that?
No.
They've never said what you just said. In 20, 30 years, they've never said the important fact of what exactly you just said. They'll call it a roar. They'll pick out the crazy guy who missed three meals and starved to death stuck on the highway. They'll pick that guy, but they won't pick the biomechanics of what it does to every cell.
I don't think they understand it. I think they're afraid.
Do they understand it? I think they enjoy the negativity of it. They need the negative sensation.
They're jumping on the bandwagon. They enjoy the negativity of it. They try to link it to negative things as many times as possible.
Reduce
it. When is the last time you heard so-and-so died? A nicotine overdose or something related straight to tobacco or nicotine, or oh my god, let's do a big story. This guy died of alcoholism. You don't hear it, man. You don't hear it. There's too many of them. Too many deaths.
There's like thousands per day.
Yeah, and when you have one that's an athlete remotely related to any type of PED or steroid death, they attack the testosterone right away, or the chemical right away, which is retarded, ridiculous, they're uninformed, and very uneducated people. And that's what we're talking about.
If that's not the biggest point you just brought up, you just said, your body doesn't produce any level of nicotine. It doesn't produce any level of alcohol at all. But it's on every corner in the nation, and they're charging taxes on it.
Exactly. And it's legal, they're charging taxes. And people who are making money is the government. That's it. It's really that simple. Taxation. Where does the taxes go to? Our government.
And so there still hasn't been one documented from hormone therapy, but they put that name on it called Roid, the steroid name on it.
You know, if you really think about it, the word Roid is it's a lot scarier than a testosterone or chemical. Think about it. If you hear the word Roid or chemical, which one sounds scarier? If you didn't know the English language, if someone said the word Roid or chemical, God, that word Roid sounds menacing.
It's so funny, he named his turtles Roid Rage.
Roid Rage. It's used.
These turtles. Because it's comical, is why he named these turtles.
Right. It is comical.
By the way, how the turtles?
They're fine. They're huge.
Okay, good. They're good.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, okay, let's go to the next one. Here.
Pause it real quick.